The scientific method is a systematic approach to research. It's a process that helps us learn more about everything around us. And what it boils down to is we do the best we can with the information that we have. If better information comes along and disproves something that we used to think was true, we need to change our conclusions. So let's say every time you do laundry, you end up with an unmatched sock. You want to know where all your missing socks are going. You've just defined the problem. Defining the problem is step one of the scientific method. You think that your missing socks might be in the washer. That's a hypothesis. So step two is defining a hypothesis. But a hypothesis is a tentative explanation for experimental results. Right now, we don't have any experimental results. We have no data whatsoever to back up this hypothesis. It's basically just a guess. So, step three, we need to actually perform an experiment. And in this case, the experiment is going to be, let's actually look in the washer and see if socks are there. By making observations about the contents of the washer, you're contributing to the body of knowledge. And if the missing socks all happen to be there, then great. This supports the hypothesis. If a hypothesis survives many, many experimental tests of its validity, it can become a theory. A theory is a unifying principle that explains facts and/or the laws based on them. But theories, too, keep being reevaluated. If better information comes along that disproves a theory, even if we've believed it to be true for centuries, that theory needs to be discarded. If experiments give consistent results that can concisely be summarized, that's called a law. An example would be Newton's second law of motion. I can write it as force equals mass times acceleration. I can use this equation to calculate the force with which socks of various masses hit the floor when I drop them, based on acceleration due to Earth's gravity. If these socks are dropped from the same height, the sock with more mass hits the floor with greater force. But the scientific method isn't always working this smoothly. You don't always find things in the first place you look. Let's go back and consider what would have happened if we never found those missing socks in the washer. The hypothesis was wrong, and it needs to be discarded or modified. It does not matter how many hypotheses you come up with and how many experiments you perform. If your hypothesis is not supported by data, it needs to be discarded or modified until you find a hypothesis that is supported by data. Then it can contribute to the body of knowledge. Scientists shy away from ever saying that they're certain about anything because better data might be collected someday. A theory is something that is true to the best of our knowledge, but a hypothesis isn't. Some hypotheses can be terrible, like my washer is a portal to another universe, or one sock of each pair will shrink to oblivion until it is no more. Or there's a sock fairy that steals unmatched socks and leaves money. Proving or disproving a hypothesis can take years or even centuries. Sometimes the technology that's necessary to gather data might not be available. But experiments are devised to try to disprove a hypothesis in hopes that it survives, in hopes that it can become a theory. We do the best we can with the information that we have. If better information comes along and disproves something that we believed to be true, we need to change our minds. Thanks for watching Chemistry in a Nutshell. If you feel that I've earned it, please like this video and subscribe to my channel.